Sarah Palin's family was thrust into the national spotlight in 2008 when Sen. John McCain picked her to be his GOP running mate in the campaign for president. Now, after years of attention that accompanied Palin's role as a popular and controversial conservative advocate and media personality, the family is once again under scrutiny, this time after her eldest son was arrested on suspicion of breaking into his parents' home and beating his father. Painful new details emerged Monday about the arrest of Track Palin, who at one point pleaded with his father to shoot him, according to a police affidavit. The document said his father, Todd, was brandishing a gun but refused to shoot. After his arrest Saturday, Track Palin, 28, was charged with first-degree burglary, fourth-degree assault, and criminal mischief. He remains in custody. The police affidavit, contained in a court filing, describes a chaotic scene at the family's home in Wasilla, Alaska, when Palin confronted his father over a truck he wanted to pick up. Todd Palin had told him not to come to the home because Track Palin had been drinking and taking pain medication, according to the affidavit and charging documents. Track told him he was going to come anyway to beat his ass, according to an affidavit filed by Wasilla police officer Adam LaPointe. When Todd Palin, 53, confronted his son at the door with a pistol, the younger Palin broke a window and entered the house and started beating his father, according to court filings. Palin pushed his father to the ground and hit him repeatedly on the head, the documents say. Sarah Palin called police at 8:30 p.m. and said her son was freaking out and was on some type of medication. When police arrived, they saw Todd and Sarah Palin fleeing the house in separate vehicles, Todd Palin with blood running down his face and Sarah Palin looking visibly upset, the documents say. Police confronted Track Palin in the home. He called them peasants and told them to lay down their weapons, according to the documents. Eventually, Palin left the house and was placed in handcuffs. He told police that when he arrived at the house, his father aimed his gun at him, and he urged his father to shoot him several times before entering the house, according to the documents. When police interviewed Todd Palin, he was bleeding from multiple cuts to his head, and one ear was discharging liquid, the documents say. There is no record of an interview with Sarah Palin. The Wasilla Police Department did not respond to a question about whether its officers interviewed her. A judge set Track Palin's bail at $5,000. He remains in custody at the Matsu pretrial facility in Palmer, Alaska. Palmer Distance Attorney Roman J. Kaylee TX said that if Palin remains in custody, his office must take the case to the grand jury within 10 days. If Palin pays bail and is released, prosecutors will have 20 days to go before the grand jury. An attorney for Sarah and Todd Palin declined to comment on the case. Given the nature of actions addressed by law enforcement and the charges involved, the Palins are unable to comment further, John Temesson said in a statement.